Hi, it's Jen from Peanut Butter Runner. This is the No Makeup on a Friday Night version of Jen from Peanut Butter Runner, so welcome. This is going to be a video post. I hope everybody's long weekend is off to a really great start. I'm going to be hanging out here in Charlotte, although it seems like most people in Charlotte are at the beach or in the mountains or somewhere fun. But it's supposed to be beautiful weather here, so hopefully I can camp out by the pool and get some relaxation. Housework, yard work, all that kind of good stuff done that I never have time to do. So I asked for topic requests on Facebook today, as always, and I got a few good suggestions. So let's go ahead and dive into those. Okay, the first one that I'm going to cover is from Lisbeth, and she says, how you dealt with working out back when you were working in an office and the lack of motivation that can occur after sitting for 8+ hours. Also, good stretching exercises for those who are very inflexible. She can't even touch her toes. Let's talk about the first part of her question first, and that's about motivation when you're working a desk job. I totally get the wanting to go home and just like sit on the couch and relax after a long day, but you have to think that you've been staring at your computer all day, you've been sitting at your office all day, and to go home and like stare at the TV or just to hang out at home, you're just going to be doing more sitting. So I used to just really focus on that whole idea of you won't regret the workout after it happens, and seriously, 10 times out of 10, not even 9 out of 10. I always felt so much better after I just got up and got myself moving. So I would just encourage you just to remind yourself that you're not going to regret the workout. And I used to kind of bargain with myself, okay, I'll just run 1 mile, or I can leave if I really am not feeling this exercise class. And always, 10 or 15 minutes into it, I was so glad that I did it. Then once I got home, I felt so accomplished, and then I was really ready to relax and settle in and cook dinner and all that stuff. Alternatively, you could become a morning workout person or lunch if it's feasible, but that's really hard for girls. But morning workouts allow you to just go ahead and knock it out, and then you can have that time after work to decompress. I know especially that it's hard to work out after work if you're working late. I mean, at that point, I agree. The last thing I want to do is go work out. I just want to go home. But if you are getting off at 5:30 and you do have that window, I would say just suck it up, get it done, and you'll feel so much better after. So that's going to lead me into another question, which we've talked about this a couple times before, but Meg wanted tips for working out in the morning. She's recently had to switch her exercise routine to the AM, and she's seriously struggling. I get out there, but I have zero endurance, stamina, and energy. I get that. I find for me that it's easier when I'm working out in the morning to do something like yoga or easy running. There is no way that I could do CrossFit at 6 a.m. I mean, my body would be like, what are we doing? That said, I did teach body pump at 6 a.m. on a Monday for 2 years. It was brutal. And it did get easier, but it never felt as strong as my Thursday night body pump class. I still love to get up and practice yoga first thing in the morning. It's my very favorite time to practice yoga. So I think maybe find a workout that's going to work for you that early in the morning. Maybe it's not doing high intensity or, weightlifting kind of activities. Maybe it's more just light jogging, yoga, exercise classes where someone else can lead you through it and you can just be asleep. And then as your body starts to adjust to the workouts, then maybe you can start dialing it up a little bit. But just give yourself time. When I switched to morning workouts, it took my body forever to figure out how we needed to regulate systems and how I needed to fuel and what I should eat and all that kind of stuff. But stick with it. I promise it does get easier. Okay, let's jump on. This is the one that everyone seemed to want to hear my take on the most. And it's regarding nutritional balance, and it's from Natalie. She says, you seem to enjoy your meals and not be afraid to. For example, throw in some extra cheese and have the sauce without feeling it's unhealthy. You know? Also, have you ever had any bad food relationships or exercise habits? Okay. As far as nutritional balance goes for me, I kind of tell myself that I can have one, like, I try to say one dessert a day. So if I have a cupcake at lunch, I'm probably not going to have ice cream after dinner as well. And that said, I usually like to save my sweet until later in the day because, I don't know, it just feels more rewarding when I have dessert in the evening. Also, as far as, like, the cheese, like, the grilled cheese with fried green tomatoes that I ate the other night, it tasted so good that I didn't even feel slightly guilty about eating it. And I don't eat like that all the time. So I guess I just remind myself that, you know, maybe I'm 70-30, 80-20, you know, somewhere in the clean, not clean, splurging, whatever range. But it all evens out. And I was having this conversation with someone at Metro a couple days ago, and we were just talking about how we could be perfect eaters, but then our life wouldn't be very fun. Like, we're willing to maybe not look exactly how we want to look if we can enjoy, like, our nightly glass of wine. So I think you just have to figure out what your ratio is for how you can still splurge and eat things that you enjoy while still feeling really good in your own body. So I feel like that all kind of works out for me. So going into the talking about exercise or food habits, you know, when I was in high school, I definitely had food issues like most high school girls do. But luckily I have a mom who was just super awesome and on top of all that and made sure that she was just a really good coach for me on eating, never restricting any certain types of foods. So I really felt like I was able to move past that. It was really just when I was cheerleading in high school. And once I got out of that, like having to weigh in every week and all that crap, I was able to kind of let that go. So that was probably like the biggest time I struggled was in high school. But now that I'm so physically active, I feel so strong in my body. I just look at food now. I love food. I love to cook. I love to eat. I love to share it with other people. And so for me now, it's more of like an enjoyable experience. It's something that fuels my body so that I can be strong. That's kind of where I am with all that now. Maybe we can go more into depth on that at a later date, but maybe that gave you a little bit of insight. And then, let's see, let's go over one more. Okay. Dan Keller. Hi, Dan. From the Omega Nation here in Charlotte, I do clinics for his running group, said, balancing types of workouts, reasons why cross-training benefits whatever sport you are pursuing. So this is coming from Dan, who's an endurance athlete. He's a marathon runner. And I just think, I strongly, strongly believe that more miles is not always going to make you a faster runner. Like, yes, you have to put the miles in and you have to do the speed work to become a better and a faster runner. But also, when you become a stronger individual overall, your performance is going to enhance in whatever sport that you are training in. Also, when you add in things like yoga, your body's going to feel better so that you can train harder. So that's why I'm such a proponent of switching up your workouts and cross-training and doing different things. Your body needs it. To be the strongest version of yourself that you can be, you have to do more than just one type of physical activity. Y'all know that I'm not totally on the CrossFit like Kool-Aid bandwagon, but one of the things that I do enjoy about CrossFit is that it is so varied and you are doing so many different things. You're running, you're jumping, you're lifting heavy weights, you're lifting your body weight. You know, it's a big mix of everything. So I just I'm going to take it to the grave that you should mix it up. And this is coming from a girl that used to only run. I mean, I thought running was the end all be all. And it's still my favorite thing to do. If I just need to get out and get a quick workout in, I'm going to go and I'm going to run 3 or 5 miles. It's just my favorite way to get a quick workout in. But that said, I cannot imagine only doing yoga now or only doing CrossFit now or only running now. I love having a mix of different activities. So we are approaching the 10-minute mark. My little puppy needs for me to pay attention to her. Do y'all want to say hello to her? Sully, come here, baby. Come here, Sully. Come here. Can you say hi to everyone? Come here. Come here. There she is. Sully, right here. All right. So we are going to go ahead and settle in so that we can enjoy the rest of our weekend. I hope that you guys have a good Memorial Day, and I will see you soon. Bye.